Thank you. Some things have to be modified. That sounds cool. That's actually annoying.
there is nothing better than loving the people and the area that you're covering. Boston 25 News is your local station.
Internet connection's really low.
Millions of federal workers who could be caught in the middle, furloughed, without pay if the shutdown happens.
No money for the mortgage, for the cars, for the insurance, for the bill that we have.
The Senate is working on one bipartisan measure that would fund the government through November 17th and includes more aid for Ukraine. House Speaker Kevin McCarthy bypassing that effort, instead backing a bill in his chamber that includes more money for border enforcement. Fellow Republicans are on board.
So what I'm hoping comes out of the House this week, even though I don't love it, is at least a short-term stopgap measure that also deals with the border.
Our job description up here is real short. It's take care of your constituency and it's have oversight of the federal government.
But Democrats blame the gridlock on infighting in the Republican Party, saying they can't get on the same page as far as what they're willing to fund.
This is completely avoidable. House Republicans should not be doing this. They seem dead set on sending us toward a shutdown.
It's why people hate this city and they hate what Congress does. You've got a Speaker of the House that's about to shut down the government because a number of his members that are radicals.
House lawmakers have been told to stay flexible this weekend because there could be another vote. From the Washington Newsbury, I'm Blair Miller.
As many as 70,000 child care centers are at risk of shutting down this weekend. The move could possibly affect more than 3 million children across the country. Parents are bracing for what could be a devastating shift, as some may need to stop working just to care for their children.
Bitch.
Financial experts say the solution lies with local governments.
The state and local areas can look at their existing regulations and say which one of these are not actually increasing the quality of the care that's being received.
Some lawmakers are working to extend child care funding before months expire Saturday. The United
the
Workers Union is expanding its strike. About 7,000 more members walked off the job Friday at a Ford plant in Chicago and a General Motors facility in Lansing, Michigan. UAW is asking for raises, better benefits, and job protections. About 25,000 members are now involved in the strike that started September 15th. Stellantis, which owns Chrysler, Jeep, Dodge, and Ram, was spared in this round.
Stellantis made significant progress. 2009 cost of living allowance, the right not to cross the picket line, as well as the right to strike over product amendments for plant closures and outsourcing moratoriums.
Automakers say they can't afford to meet all of the union's demands. The country is mourning the loss of Senator Dianne Feinstein. She's the longest serving female senator in U.S. history. Kirsten Garris is in Washington with a look at what this means for the balance of power.
Democrats will maintain a slim majority in the Senate. It's now shifting to 50 before none. Senator Dianne Feinstein was the longest-serving woman senator in U.S. history. She was also the oldest current member at the time of her death. Feinstein's health became a topic of increasing scrutiny for most of this year.
Printify has a new AI program that helps you do mock-ups.